excited about the film yourself?
Yeah, very much so. No, very much so. So I have to hold my hands up. I don't know a lot about the film or the books, but my daughter here does, fortunately. So she's just been filling us in on what we've got in store. So yeah, looking forward to it.
We're going to test you, see how much you've been listening. What she told you about the books and films? Why are you excited about this one in particular?
Because she is, mainly. So I'm intrigued. You know, I've heard it's funny, very creative, and I'm intrigued. I genuinely, you know, don't know much. So yeah, it's going to be a bit of a learning curve, steep learning curve. She told me all sorts, by the way. She told me loads, but she went into the story mode, so I can tell you about loaded diaper and all these different things, but it's kind of, I don't know, we'll see.
I believe that you're an expert. Obviously these books and these films have meant a lot to kids all around the world. When you were growing up, were there any particular books or films that meant a lot to you in the same way?
Well, it's funny, I was just flicking through the book, and I don't know if I might be way offline here, but I almost reminded me of Adrian Mole. I don't know if that's kind of a, because it's sort of a reflective thing. It's quite sort of, it's a bit of a story about self-awareness and all that sort of stuff, isn't it? So, I don't know whether that's true, but it seemed like that was a similar style.
As a parent, how valuable do you think films and books can be as a tool to teach children and help them deal with different issues like bullying and first crushes and all the kind of stuff that these wonderful stories focus on?
That's what it's all about, isn't it? I mean, you know, the thing that amazes me, I mean, my two are 6 and 8, but they're like sponges. So, you know, Elise here will remember everything about this film. She's already, you know, I mean, you've already seen it, haven't you? But she will remember it start to finish, all the names, and it's just amazing how much they take in. So I think your point's valid. You know, they learn so much from the films, and if they can, get on in life as a result of what they've seen here and just sort of take it all in, that's what a great thing to do.
You mentioned the word amazing there. I think that's a fairly good description for London 2012. We spoke to you a lot in the run-up to the Olympics about how much it was going to mean to people, particularly young people here in the capital. I guess now it's all over. What do you think? What was your Olympic experience like?
Oh, it was sensational. I mean, I still feel, I mean, it blew everyone away. It really did. I think even the most optimistic of people were surprised of how successful it was, from the delivery, the stadia, how people moved around. You know, it was just sensational start to finish. And then of course we blew away all the targets, the performance targets, the medals, I mean. 65 medals, wasn't it, in total in the Olympics. And then of course the Paralympics, that everyone was thinking, well, how are we gonna live up to it? And it was even better again. So sensational, very, very proud.
It's given us a real headache for Sports Personality of the Year. Have you got any particular tips? Is there anyone you're really keeping your fingers crossed for that one?
Well, what I would say is, in any other year, any one of the 10 final candidates could win, from Nicola Adams to Sarah Story to David Weir to Jess Ennis, Mo Farah. Bradley Wiggins probably stands out as a Tour de France winner and then, of course, Olympic champion.
He's done this very, very proud, hasn't he?
Oh, I mean, that's unprecedented, what he did. I mean, I don't think many people thought that was possible to come off the back of the Tour to then go to the Games. I'd probably be leaning towards Jess Ennis, though. I think Jess was the face, she was the poster girl, kind of the Olympics. And I think she's just got such a lovely, warm smile. And it is a personality vote as much as it is a performance vote. So I've got a sneaky feeling Jess Ennis is going to win it.